Okay, so here's an egg. Looks like a normal hard-boiled egg. Peel it, cut it in half, and there is no yolk. Now, maybe you immediately know what's going on here, but for me, the first time I saw these, they really kind of messed with my head. So for those of you playing along at home, how do you think this is done? Is it A, something happening before the kitchen? Is the chicken farmer just messing around with the fertilization process? Or is Mr. Rooster just firing blanks? Or B, is this something happening in the kitchen? I mean, like, this is the same cuisine that's given us fish that looks like kanji, tofu that looks like goose skin, and chicken that looks like tofu. So just removing the yolk wouldn't exactly be a stretch. But, like, how would the egg be staying the same volume? So just take a second to answer in your head. And the answer is yes. Let me explain. See, you might be familiar with the tradition of balut in Southeast Asia. That is, that snack of semi-developed duck eggs that sort of tastes halfway between a boiled egg and a hunk of chicken. Less well known is that China also has a balut culture, in pockets, the northeast of the country being one. Now, if you're making balut, as a sort of side product, you also end up getting some of what's referred to in the Philippines as penoy, infertile incubated eggs. So over time, in China's northeast, those yolkless, or I guess equally whiteless, penoy-style eggs ended up getting really popular Chinese barbecue joints. They're practically made to skewer and grill. They ended up getting so popular that demand outstripped supply and vendors innovated. So, here's how they're usually made nowadays. Take a few eggs. Here we got five, and using the thick end of a chopstick, carefully crack it, and using the thin end, break open the narrow top. In just a sec, we're going to be putting the egg back in, so definitely clean up that little hole there with a pair of tweezers. Then, to your bowl of eggs, toss in a half tablespoon of water, together with a half teaspoon each salt and jianshui, Chinese lye water. This will give the eggs that sort of Pinoy-esque bite. Then whisk all that in a zigzag motion, really trying not to incorporate too much air, all till no stray strands of egg white remain. Then pass that through a strainer, knock it a couple times as if you were dealing with a cake batter, and skim off those bubbles. Definitely do a bang-up job getting out those air bubbles, though. Otherwise, you could be looking at some egg explosions on your hands. Now put all that back in the eggshells, filling them about 90% of the way, and if you happen to have any heat-safe Easter egg molds on hand, that'd make your life even easier. Then toss those in a steamer over some bubbling water, and steam them over a low flame for 20 minutes. Flame must be low, else you'll be running that same egg explosion risk. Then, after that time, transfer over to some cool water and peel. And then, with that, you've got yourself some Northeastern-style solid eggs. So, here's how to eat them. Option number one, toss them over a grill. Just cut them in half, put them on a skewer, and sprinkle over the cumin lamb seasoning that we went over in our BBQ spice mix video, which I'll also copy for you down in the description box. Unfortunately, though, we still aren't allowed to grill out here on our balcony, so let's also show you how you can eat these stir-fried. So, first cut your eggs into 3 to 4 slices, breaking out your now duo-tasker crinkle-cut knife if you got one. Then just cut them in half, and these are good to fry. So then, to stir-fry, first, long yao. Get your wok piping hot, shut off the heat, add in your oil, here about 1 tablespoon, and give it a swirl to get a nice nonstick surface. Heat on high now, add in your sliced eggs, a quarter of a sliced onion, and 2 cloves of minced garlic. Fry it until the surface of the egg starts to blister slightly, about 1 minute, then add in a half tablespoon each of chili powder and cumin powder. Fry that till fragrant, about another minute, then swirl in a teaspoon of soy sauce. Quick mix, then season with a quarter teaspoon sugar and a sprinkle of MSG, and go in with 15 grams each chopped scallion and cilantro. Another quick mix, top it with a bit of toasted sesame seeds, and out.
So besides the way that we showed in the video, there are also a couple other ways that you can make this egg. One of them is that they will have a little spinning gadget. You can put the egg in and then you pull it and it will just spin. And the whole egg will just become like solid. So right, check out the recipe in the description box. A big thank you for everyone that's supporting us on Patreon. And of course, subscribe for more Chinese cooking videos.